ever tried to edit a PDF and got stuck because every tool you found was either paid or had a watermark? Finding a reliable PDF editor is actually impossible, but I'm going to show you today 5 completely free ways to edit your PDFs. Whether you want to work online or offline, these methods are quick and easy and won't cost you a penny. Plus, you'll find all the links in the description below. iLovePDF is a powerful online all-in-one toolkit for handling PDFs efficiently. You can merge, split, compress, and even convert your PDF to Word. You can even add page numbers or watermarks. The UI is really beginner-friendly and requires no account for the basic features. I love this tool, especially when I want to compress PDFs to send by email or any other form of communication. So let's go across and test this out. Compress right here. And let's add our file. You can simply drag and drop, or if you want to have anything that's on your Google Drive or even in your Dropbox, you can select it directly from there. Now, as you see, you have a file here that's 2.2 kilobytes. So that's around 2 MB. Now, it's better to send around 1 MB on email. People's inboxes do get full up. So let's just go ahead and click it. Now, let's just wait. You have different levels of compression right here. If you want extreme, your quality of your images is really going to degrade. And if you have less compression, then your size is going to be a little bit higher. Let's all go for the recommended one over here. Now, if you have a look, you can see from 2 MB, it's coming to 1 MB and it's 49% smaller. You can continue here and you can add things, you can split the PDFs, you can rotate it, and you can do a whole host of other options right here. Now, once you've viewed it, you can just download it. And once you've downloaded it, we can simply see what the file size is. As you can see, it's right there, just 1 MB. The next thing we can do is merge PDF. Now, let's select the PDF files. Now we want to add the employee contract and the employee policy together. So let's just select both of these documents right here and press open. Now you can see that you've got two of your documents and you can put them here. You can put them back to front as well. Let's merge them. Very easy. They've been merged and now just download it once again. You can have a look here and we have 5 pages of all of the documents merged together. Very easy to use. Moving on to PDFescape. This is a browser-based editor and it's really ideal for form filling, adding text, annotations, and even shapes, all without needing to download any software. It's quick, reliable, especially for lightweight tasks. Now let's start to add and let's replace some text right here. You can even download the desktop version if you want. Let's go, we'll do the free online version. Let's upload a PDF. You can choose the file or drag it and drop it right here. Now let's go across and sign this right here. Press open. Okay, and now you can see that you have your PDF over here. Now the nice thing here is you can change it to things like Word, JPEG, as well as Create. Here you go, you have sponsored links here. However, you can see that it is within the same ecosystem of PDF. Now if you add here, you have an insert, you have a sticky note, strike through, rectangle, or many other different things there. Let's add a sticky note right here. Now we can just drag right here. We've got a sticky note. Click into it and here is a note. Okay, you can apply that. And when you send that, you can easily see these in any of the other things. Okay. Now say that you want to send this and you want to white mark anything. You can simply click onto this, white out, and say that you want to just take away this governing law. Let's just highlight this. And it simply gets redacted, so it's completely moved from your PDF. You can take this, you can save it now, and you can move on. This tool is pretty interesting. The only thing you can't do is if you have any scanned PDF, it doesn't really detect it very well, and there isn't any OCR available. The third tool that we have is Canva PDF Editor. Yes, Canva. It's known for its graphic design, Canva's PDF editor is really perfect for giving your documents a beautiful professional look. You can just drag and drop elements very easily, and you can brand your colors, insert your icons, and totally revamp any standard PDF. Now let's upload PDF from here. Let's go in and let's just put in the employee contract once again. As you can see, it does take time and just opens up in Canva. And out of all of the editors, this one takes just a little bit longer than the others. Okay, now you see that you have all your elements over here, and you can simply add any other elements that you want, from your brand icons to anything else right here. If you want to add your brand colors, you can add something completely different right here. You can see that it's very easy to add. Now, the only disadvantage here is you can't use it for OCR support, but it can help you, especially when you have scanned PDFs. You can use it for visual layering alone. Now, the fourth tool here is DocHub. DocHub is really a signing and annotation tool that integrates very well with Google Drive and Dropbox. It's amazing for signing legal documents, reviewing PDFs collaboratively, and filling up forms online. Use DocHub to digitally sign contracts or forms, fill out PDF forms quickly, and annotate for quick review. Now, let's just import a document right here. Select a file. And let's go ahead and see. We'll select the contract here, press OK. And now when it says ready, you can just go down here and create a document. Now it tells you simply over here, if you want to edit, you can secure it, you can share and collaborate, and you can e-sign as well. Here's a page manager, and it goes through a little bit of things of how it can actually be used. And get started. So let's annotate it right here. And let's type in here. Okay, let's go. Make a change here. Very, very easy to do. Okay, now let's just move all the way down and say that we want to use it for a signature or something. We could easily do that as well. Let's go to sign, create a signature. You can use a scanning on your phone, you can use your initials, and you can use your phone. So right here, you can text me a link and sign it, which is really, really super cool. So if you just type in your number here, you can send a digital signature for you to do it. You can upload an image and you can sign right here. So let's just do that, save as default. And once again, this is something that's very easy to do, and you can simply just add your signature right here. So let's click in here. And let's use the signature and just drag it right here. Now you can see that this is simply so easy to do. What you can do with this document is you can share it directly with somebody over here, shareable link, or you can send a sign request as well. Now here you can download it and export it into any other format and send it by email as well. But this is a very, very easy to use tool. Now you can use scanned PDFs for annotation, but not for editing text. And OCR is not available in this tool at all. Now the fifth and last tool is Word. Anything in Word 2013 or newer can open and edit PDFs natively. It converts the file into a Word document and lets you edit it as normal, and then allows you to re-export it back to a PDF. It's a great option for content-heavy documents. Now let's convert an PDF. Now you can drag and drop it in here, or you can open it directly from your open options right here. So let's go to File, let's go to Open, and let's open the employee contract once again. Now, let's have a look. It will just take a few moments and you will get up this pop-up here. So we're going to convert the PDF into a Word document. Might take a while, but let's go ahead and do it. And if there are lots of graphics in your document, it can disrupt the way that it's laid out, but just keep an eye on that. This is really a lot more useful for content-heavy documents, easy to use. You do have partial OCR here, and you can use the built-in OCR for really taking any scanned documents as well. It does give it to you in a protective view, but you can see that I can simply just add and change any of the information right here. So let's just go here and say that we want to change this to even 60 days, for example. You will have to enable this, and it will tell you this again. So let's just change this to 60, for example. Okay, and now once it's done, you simply just go back here and you save as, go down here and save as PDF. Avoid using save as PDF because it will take you over to the PDF of Adobe and takes a little bit longer. If you simply just do PDF and press save, press okay, add it to the new folder and it will save right there. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like and subscribe and share with your colleagues and friends. Until next time, I'm Samina Gori. Happy productivity.